What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So I am going to show you guys how to run the PSP emulator for the Nintendo Switch, better known as the PlayStation Portable emulator. Now you need to have custom firmware running. If you want to know how to do that, please make sure to follow my tutorials. Just go to the link in the description, download the latest version of the emulator, which is 1.9.3+. You're going to get a RAR file, which is this. Just extract the contents. You're going to get the folder, copy the Switch folder, connect your SD card, or you can also remotely connect your Switch like I did and paste it to the root of your SD card. Replace the files in the destination and that's it. Don't ask me how to gather the ROMs because I cannot promote piracy. You can just create a separate folder somewhere on the base, on the root of your SD card. I did it inside the PPSP folder, which is here. I just kept all the ROM files here. And yeah, after making sure of all of those, I'm going to show you guys how to set the emulator up and run the games properly or in the best possible way on the Nintendo Switch itself. Before moving on to that, I just want to tell you guys something about the emulator itself. It has been posted by the developer. So you're going to see on the homebrew menu that there are two versions, the GLES2 and the GL version. Use the GLES2 version for graphics hungry game like God of War games or the Metal Gear Solid. It says like, you know, GTA or any kind of other troubling games. Otherwise, the GL version is always recommended and it's far more stable and bug-free. So I'm going to make another, you know, demonstrative video where I'm running those games and talk about those. But for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to be using just the GL version because it's just the basic tutorial where I set things up and, you know, show you, demonstrate how well the emulator runs. Apart from that, it says that all the config files resides in the Switch PPSP folder. The path cannot be changed for the time being. It says you can copy your PPSP files from RetroArch core, save files, PPSP. RetroArch is a multi-core emulator. It also has the PPSP emulator core. So let's just say you have some save files and stuff like that. Just copy the save files from the RetroArch and this path, just follow this path and then just, you know, paste them into the PPSP folder and it should be fine. So it says save files are compatible, save states are not. It's a work in progress, as you can see. Due to a tool chain issue, starting like 15 plus games in a row might lead to a crash. Obviously, just try to keep it minimal because the Switch has limited amount of RAM that it can dedicate for the homebrew apps and also the overlays. Do not put too much stress on the system itself. Play the games that you want to play and do not try to dump everything at once just because you have a memory card with a huge gut. Don't do that. So the most important notes are about any kind of crashes that you might encounter. It says if you're using any method of loading the emulator other than Atmosphere's title redirection feature, do not report any issues that you encounter. What this means is that you have to use full RAM mode. It says do not use NSPs. And yeah, you can support this amazing developer through Patreon. These developers are doing a tremendous amount of good work for all of us, the end users. There's lots of change logs and stuff like that, but do not worry about that. I'll just follow what I'm going to show you. Should be good to go. I'm going to be showing the setup process on the Nintendo Switch itself. Alright guys, so on the Nintendo Switch, the very first thing what we're going to do is access full RAM mode. In order to do that, press and hold the R button and run an application, except tinfoil. So applications are basically the games or the softwares. The reason I'm explaining this is somebody had an issue where he was not able to access full RAM mode because he was selecting one of these instead of the applications. So these are actually options. These are the applications. So let's just go ahead and access full RAM mode. It will take us to the homebrew menu screen and here, okay, I can let go of this one. And how to know that you're on full RAM mode? Here, otherwise it would have been written applet version. So PPSP GL and PPSP GLES2. Only use this one when you're running graphics hungry games. As I've told you guys that I'm going to make a separate demonstrative tutorial where I'll be showing by running some high graphics processor intensive games. So here, this is going to be your screen. You're going to look for the ROMs where you have placed them. Depending on the placement of the ROMs, you're going to have to look for the ROM files. I'll just show you some of the settings and stuff. You can see the first option is the graphics option. Everything is pre-configured. You don't have to do anything except for minor tweakings here and there. To rendering resolution, this here is where you're going to select the rendering resolution to 5x, going to clarify the image quality or upscale the image quality a bit more. For any reason, if your game starts to lag, you can select the lower options. For this game, rendering resolution is working great. Just scroll down a bit more. Upscaling level, just set it to 2x, and the rest of the stuffs you don't have to play around with them. Just don't try to put too much pressure. That is going to create a disbalance and also might lead to a bad experience. On the audio here, you don't need to do anything much. And under controls, go to control mapping. Everything has been pre-configured like I've said, but just in case if you want to map the buttons according to your preference, you can do that pressing the B button and then just, you know, assign the keys, the desired keys. So this is according to the button layout of the PlayStation's controller. Let's just head back and run the game and show you guys how well the emulator runs. There are no lags or stutters. The game looks flawless as well. The game also runs great. There is no stuttering or sound stuttering. Everything runs amazing. It's actually running at full 60 FPS with 100% speed. The PPSP emulator is a very well-made emulator. Oh, one more thing, I totally forgot. If you want to bring up the emulator's options, just press both the analog sticks at once, and here you're going to get all these options. Do not try to change the video settings through here. When you're in game, it's going to crash the application. And yeah, here you can save through the emulator itself. That's pretty much it. So I already saved it. As you can see, here are the options, save state and load state. And there you go. This was the PPSP emulator for the Nintendo Switch. So that was it for this one. If you like this video, please drop in a like and subscribe. Don't forget to comment. Please make sure to check out the tutorial from start to end. That is going to give you a hassle-free experience. For now, Dr. Root7 signing off. Peace.